Hi students, this is Jyoti Mix, your computer teacher. Children, I think you all of you enjoyed your holidays well. From today onwards, we will concentrate on our studies. We are learning second lesson from our textbook. That is page number 15. Children, all of you open your textbook and see. Page number 15, second lesson, memory. In last class, we learned about memory. In that memory lesson, we learned what is data, what are instructions, what is information, and what are binary digits, how many types of memories are there, primary memory and secondary memory. In primary memory, we learned about RAM, ROM, PROM, EPROM, EEPROM, we learned in last class. Okay, today we are going to learn what is secondary memory. This is what is secondary memory. Secondary memory. If you see children, we will call secondary memory as auxiliary memory and non-volatile memory. So, why we are calling these secondary memory as auxiliary memory and non-volatile memory, and what are the examples of secondary memory, what is the function of secondary memory, these all now we are going to learn. Okay children, see page number 17, secondary memory. Secondary memory or external memory is where programs and data are stored on a long-term basis. It is different from primary memory in the fact that it is not directly accessible by the CPU. It is also called auxiliary memory. So, see children, secondary memory is we will called as external memory. Secondary memory, another name of secondary memory is what? Another name of secondary memory is what? External memory. Okay. So, what we are calling that primary memory? It is primary memory is internal memory. And coming to here, secondary memory is external memory. Okay, primary memory is internal memory and secondary memory is external memory and auxiliary memory. So children, what we are storing in this secondary memory, it will store permanently. Long term basis, we will store our data in these secondary memory devices. Okay, it is different from primary memory and it is not directly accessible by the CPU. Okay. So, it is called auxiliary memory. The secondary memory is non-volatile memory, that is, it does not depend on power supply. The secondary or external storage devices have much larger storage capacity, floppy disk, hard disk, CD, compact disk. CD means compact disk. DVD, digital versatile disk. DVD means digital versatile disk. And flash drive are some examples of secondary storage devices. So children, why we are saying that primary, this is secondary memory is not accessible by CPU. Means if you observe hard drive and RAM, ROM, those all are accessible by CPU and attached to the CPU. But these secondary memories are not attached to the CPU and not accessed by the CPU. To store data in these secondary memory devices, we don't want any power supply. Okay, children? So, that's why we are calling these devices are external memory devices or auxiliary memory devices. Okay. Examples of these secondary memory devices are hard disk, CD-ROM. CD-ROM is compact disk, ROM, DVD, digital versatile disk, Blu-ray, flash drive. So, what are these secondary memory examples? How it will work? Now we will see. See children, first of all, hard disk. First of all, we will see hard disk. These are all hard disks. If you observe, this hard disk is fixed in the CPU. And this is also hard disk. This is also hard disk. What is the difference between these two hard disks? How it will work? Now we will see. A hard disk. A hard disk is a circular metal disk coated with magnetic material. It is usually sealed in a hard disk drive inside the computer. The data access speed is very fast and the data stored on a hard disk can be accessed much more quickly than data stored on a floppy disk. Hard disks come in different storage capacities from 80 GB to 1 terabyte. There are two types of hard disk. They are fixed and portable hard disk. Okay, children. So, what is hard disk means? It is a circular. It is a circular metal disk coated with magnetic material. This hard disk was coated with magnetic material. It is usually sealed in a hard disk drive inside the computer. So, this hard disk drive is attached to the CPU. Okay, children. And the data access speed is very fast in this hard disk by comparing to the floppy disk drive, okay, or CDs, okay, children. And this hard disk, we can store data 80 GB to 1 terabyte depending upon the capacity of the CPU. So, these hard disks are two types, fixed hard disk and portable hard disk. This is a fixed hard disk, this is portable hard disk. What are these two edges? We can store data in these two devices, okay. And fixed hard disk is fixed in the CPU. And portable hard disk is we can carry and it is outside of the CPU. External device, okay. See here. Fixed hard disk. A hard drive built into the case of computer is fixed. Almost every computer has a fixed hard disk drive. Okay, children. Next, in all computers, if you observe, there is a fixed hard disk drive. Okay. So, this is the fixed hard disk drive. It is attached to the CPU. Next, what is portable hard disk drive? See page number 18, portable hard disk. The external hard disk drive is used in addition to the fixed hard disk and can be taken from one place to another easily. Portable hard disks helps us to transport very large amount of data from one computer to another computer. This portable hard disk also we can connect to our computer by externally. Okay, so what is this portable hard disk drive means? We can store large amount of data. In series, we can store some limit of GBs or some limit of GBs only we can store. But coming to portable hard disk, we can store large amount of data and these portable hard disk drives we can carry from one place to another place and we can transfer data one computer to another computer by using this portable hard disk drives. Okay, children. So, this is about the hard disk. Okay, these are secondary memory devices. Okay, next coming to CD-ROM. Next coming to what is CD-ROM, now we will see. See page number 18, children. Page number 18, see CD-ROM. CD-ROM stands for Compact Disk Read-Only Memory. A wide variety of information like encyclopedia, images, videos, games and songs, songs etc. can be stored in it for future use. Its main advantage is that it is portable and can hold a large amount of data. A CD-ROM can store up to 750 MB of data. CD-ROMs have the following variations. So, children, CD-ROMs means nothing but of what? Compact disks. Compact disks. So, we know no CDs. In this CDs, we can store some informations, images, videos, games, songs. These all we can store in these CDs and we can use these CDs in for further use, future use. And in these CD-ROMs, what is the main use of these CD-ROMs? These are very lightweight and we can carry from one place to another place these CD-ROMs. And we can transfer data from one computer to another computer by using these CD-ROMs. So, in these CDs, we can store up to 750 MB data only. Okay, CD ROMs are also two types. Those are CDR, CDRW. See page number 18. CDR and CDRW. CDR means compact disc recordable. These are purchased as blanks and can then be written on by a CD writer. Once written, the disc cannot be rewritten and becomes a CD ROM. So these CD ROMs, what are these CD ROMs means? CDR means compact disc recordable. If you buy a new CD and we can store data in this CD, in the CDs by CD writer, after that we cannot rewrite that CD. Means we cannot erase that data and we cannot store new data in that CD. So those are called CD recordable, CD ROMs. So what are CDRW? Compact disc rewritable. These are purchased as blanks and can be written on by a CD writer. We can use a DVD writer to delete the old data and copy the new data. Here two types of CDs are there. One is CDR. In this CD recordable, we can only store data and we cannot rewrite it. We cannot delete. But CDRW means CD rewritable. That also we can buy blank CDs and new CDs and we can store data and we can delete this data by using DVD players. Okay, we can delete data by DVD writers and after that deleting that data we can store new data also in this CD rewritable compact discs. Okay children, so this is about the CDs. Next, coming to DVD. What are DVDs? The full form of DVD is a digital versatile disc. A DVD looks similar to a CD, but it can hold up to 25 times more than data than a CD. More data than a CD. It can store data up to 17 GB. The high storage capacity of DVD let us to access much more data than standard CD ROMs. A DVD writer or a player is needed to view the contents of a DVD. Here factum is given. The storage capacity of one DVD is equivalent to that of 25 CD ROMs. So children, DVDs are also like that CD only. But it seems like exact CD only. But here the DVD's storage capacity is more than compact disc 25 times. 25 times more than storage capacity is there in DVD compared to the CD. Okay children, so in this CD we can store 17 GB data. Up to 17 GB data we can store in this DVDs. Okay, so here what is factum given? These DVDs we can use by using DVD writers or DVD players. So the storage capacity of these DVDs is equivalent to 25 CD ROMs equal to 1 DVD. That much storage capacity a DVD can store the data. And these DVDs are and CDs we can play in our computers also, you know that. Next, coming to this is the DVD and this is DVD player. Next, coming to children, Blu-ray. So, what is Blu-ray you see? A Blu-ray disc has a capacity to hold 25 to 50 GB of data. A dual layer Blu-ray disc can hold twice that amount. They are random access devices. Blu-ray discs are used in the same manner as DVDs. Their special application is in the field of high definition video movies. They also store more qualities of HD data. So this Blu-ray also looks like DVD and CD. But the capacity of this Blu-ray is more than CDs and DVDs. So in this Blu-rays we can store 25 to 50 GB. Data. Okay, and in this Blu-ray DVDs we can store HD data, means high definition movies, high definitions images, HD. So like that videos and movies we can store in Blu-ray DVDs. Okay, this is called Ultra HD Blu-ray DVDs. Okay, next, this is also storage device and secondary memory device. Okay, Next, you all of you know this well. This is pen drive. This is pen drive or nothing but of flash drive. Flash drive is a small portable device. It can be used to store, access and transfer data. This is small in size and can be kept in a pocket. This is why we call it is a pen drive. Okay, it is also called USB drive. We can read, write, copy, delete and move data from computer to pen drive or from pen drive to computer. It comes in various storage capacities starting from 16 MB to 32 GB. It is a popular because it is easy to use and small enough to be carried in a pocket. This device is plugged into the USB port of the computer and the computer automatically detects this device. The computer system can have a maximum number of USB ports. The flash drive can be plugged into any of these storages. So children, this is, we are nowadays we are using this all. Without pen drive there is no any family is there, no? So this in this pen drive, it is very popular storage device. It is very popular secondary storage device and secondary memory device. Why? Because it is very small and we can carry, we can keep this pen drive in our pockets. And in this pen drive, we can store up to 32 GB data. And in different sizes, pen drives are coming, no? That all of you know. And we keep this pen drive to our CPU sockets, you know, that USB ports. So many USB ports are there, no, in laptops and CPUs. We can keep this pen drive in that CPU. And when we are keeping this pen drive to our laptops or in our CPUs, the automatically the CPU and the laptop, it can trace out this device and show what contents are there in this pen drive, and we can easily access this pen drive. Is it okay? And we can transfer data from pen drive to computer and computer to pen drive very easily. So that's why it is very popular nowadays. Very popular memory device, secondary memory device we are using nowadays. Okay, children, this is about the pen drive. Okay, these are all the secondary memory devices. What are those? Hard disk. In hard disk, there are two types. Fixed hard disk, portable hard disk. And next coming to the, what are those? CDs, compact discs. These are all two types, CD recordable and CD rewritable. Next coming to the DVDs, and next coming to Blu-ray, and next coming to pen drive. Okay, children, this is about the memory devices. Memory devices are two types, primary memory and secondary memory. Primary memories are two types, primary memory and secondary memory. Primary memory means RAM, ROM, EPROM, those are all primary memories. Hard disk, pen drive, DVDs, CDs, these are all secondary memory devices. Okay, children, see page number 19, here one table is given, no? Here one table is given. Shall we fill this table? I am saying, you only say these answers. Now we will do. So here given what columns? Floppy disk, hard disk, CD-ROM, pen drive. Okay. So which one is the cheapest in these four devices? Floppy disk. So here you tick floppy disk. Next, can only be written once. What is that? Only we can return once. What is that answer? CD-ROM. Nothing but of CD recordable. Next, is popular these days and has no moving parts. Which one is that? Very popular and has no moving parts. What are those? Pen drive. Okay. Next, are of two types, fixed and portable. Which one are that? Hard disk. Hard disk. Cheapest is floppy disk. Can only be written once is CD-ROM. Is popular those days, these days and has no moving parts is pen drive. And are of two types, fixed and portable, are hard disk. You write these all answers now. Okay, children. Now I completed this explanation of this lesson. Notes I will give in next class. Okay, children. Now I am closing this class. We will meet in next class. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.